Welcome to this walkthrough guide on how to create realistic AI audio with Google AI Studio. Let's be honest, recording voiceovers for your slide decks is a pain. You stumble over words, the audio quality is never quite right, and doing retakes takes forever. On the flip side, most AI text-to-speech tools sound completely robotic and soulless. But what if you could generate audio that sounds professional, emotive, and genuinely human, without recording a single word? Well, today, I'm going to show you a powerful workflow using Gemini and Google's AI Studio to direct the AI to breathe, pause, and emphasize words just like a professional voice actor. Now, we're going to start this process right here inside the standard Gemini interface. As you can see here, I've already done the heavy lifting of generating my actual presentation content. I have my slides, my bullet points, and some rough speaker notes already generated in this chat history. Now, if you're wondering how I got to this point, creating the actual slide deck content and structure using AI, well, I have a dedicated video for that. I've linked it in the description below, and it walks you through that entire creation workflow. But for this video, we're going to assume that your content is ready. Our focus now is taking those rough notes and transforming them into a script that doesn't just read well on paper, but sounds amazing when spoken aloud. To get a realistic result, we can't just ask Gemini to write a voiceover. If we do that, we just get text. What we need is metadata, instructions on how to speak. So, I'm going to paste in a very specific prompt here. Let's take a look at what this prompt does. First, I'm asking Gemini to organize the notes into a continuous narrative. But more importantly, I'm commanding it to embed detailed narration cues, like upbeat tone, pause for 1 second, or emphasize, strictly inside square brackets. Now, why square brackets, I hear you ask? Well, because later on, we need a way to tell our audio model to read the text, but obey the brackets. You can see here, it's generating the updated script for us now. Do you notice those cues? Well, you'll see things like shift to serious tone or short pause. That's the difference between a robot reading text and an AI acting out a script. And finally, look at the bottom. Because I asked it in the prompt, Gemini has provided a separate style guide paragraph. This is essentially the rule book that tells our voice generator how to interpret those signals. We'll be using this in just a moment. Now that we have our director's script, we need a tool that's powerful enough to understand it. And that is where we're going to head over to aistudio.google.com. This is Google's AI Studio. You can kind of think of this as the developer playground. Now, while the standard Gemini chat is great for ideas, AI Studio gives us access to the raw models and system-level instructions, which we need for this specific audio trick. On the dashboard, you'll see a few options. We want to start a new prompt, but we don't want text or chat. Take a look for the Audio tab. It's usually located in the center of the main dashboard. And click on that to open the audio generation interface. Once the interface loads, take a look at the options we have here. We need to select our model. You'll typically see a Flash model and a Pro model here. Now, while the Flash model is faster and is great for high volume tasks, what we need is maximum reasoning capabilities for this. So, we want the model to understand the nuance. So, select the Gemini 2.5 Pro Preview. TTS stands for text-to-speech. Now, over on the right-hand side, check out the audio mode options. By default, it might be set to multi-speaker, which is great for generating back-and-forth conversations. But since we're doing a presentation voiceover, we'll go ahead and toggle this over to single-speaker audio. This simplifies the layout substantially and focuses the AI on a single narrative track. Now we just need to transfer our brain and our body. So first, the brain. Go back to your Gemini tab and copy that short style guide or narration instructions paragraph that we generated at the end. In AI Studio, take a look for the box labeled style instructions or system instructions. Go ahead and paste it in here. This is absolutely crucial. This here tells the AI, when you see things like pause for 1 second, do not read those words, instead actually stop talking. Without this, the AI would just read your stage directions out loud. Now for the body. Go back to Gemini and copy your main narration script one slide at a time. Slide 1, slide 2, and so on, including all of those bracketed cues. Paste that right into the main text input box. Now, a pro tip here, scroll through your pasted text and scan for any placeholder text. If Gemini has put in something like insert name here, change it to your actual name now. Otherwise, the AI will confidently announce insert name here in your final audio, which obviously we definitely don't want. Okay, now we're almost there. All we need to do now is select our voice from the dropdown. There are around 30 different options that you can choose from, and you can preview them simply by using the play buttons to find the one that best suits your needs. I find Enceladus usually has a great, deep professional tone for business presentations, so I'm going to select that here. Now, once you're ready, move down and click the Run button. Now, this might take anywhere from 10 to 60 seconds to generate, depending on the amount of text that you have. While that happens, I want to show you something cool for the developers out there. See this Get Code button in the top right? If you click that, Google actually provides the exact code snippets to run this voice generation programmatically. You can grab this for Python, TypeScript, or even Google Apps Script. This is amazing if you want to build an automated tool that takes a script and auto-generates a daily news podcast or training modules using Google Apps Script. We're not going to be doing that today, but the code is right there waiting for you to take advantage of. Okay, let's close that out. It looks like our audio is finished generating. Let's take a listen to the result.
Hi everyone, thanks for joining. Today we're going to talk about the elephant in the room, or maybe I should say the robot in the room, generative AI in the workplace. We see the headlines every day, but beyond the hype, what does this actually look like for us on a Tuesday morning? We're going to break down the massive opportunities it offers, but also keep it real about the challenges we need to dodge to make it work.
Did you hear that? Did you notice the breathing and the pacing? It skipped the text in the brackets completely, but it applied the instructions. It shifted its tone. It sounds like a human reading a script, not a computer simply processing text. Now, just keep in mind that because this is generative AI, it may occasionally step out of the bounds of what we want and read the bracketed text. If that happens, simply run it again to get a new version. And once you're happy with the take, simply click the three dots option menu here and select download. This will give you a high quality WAV file ready to go. Now, simply having the file is one thing, but making it work seamlessly in your presentation is another one altogether. If you want to know how to add this audio to Google Slides and set it to autoplay perfectly when you present, I've actually created a dedicated video covering exactly how to do that. I've linked that in the description below as well, so definitely check that out to complete the entire workflow. And that is how you create professional, directed voiceovers in mere minutes. No microphones, no background noise, just perfect audio. I've put the exact prompt I used to generate the script in the description below, along with the link to the previous video on creating the slides. So go out there and experiment and give it a go yourself. Happy narrating, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.